This is basal vascular, inferior view of the cranial base. We start from the anterior aspect toward the posterior. The first structure can be seen is incisive canal. This is incisive canal or nasopalatine canal. Incisive canal transmit nasopalatine nerve and descending palatine artery. This is incisive canal. This is palate, hard palate, has two parts. Palatine process of maxillary bone and horizontal plate of palatine bone. This suture is called intermaxillary suture. This is horizontal plate of palatine bone. At the lateral border we have lesser and greater palatine foramen. Lesser and greater palatine foramen transmitting the greater and the lesser palatine artery, vein and nerves. This is posterior nasal process or spine. Posterior nasal spine or process. This is vomer. This is posterior nasal opening. Medial pterygoid plate and lateral pterygoid plate. This is medial pterygoid plate. At its lower border we have pterygoid hamillus. Lateral pterygoid plate attached medially to the medial pterygoid muscle and laterally to the lateral pterygoid muscle. Pterygoid hamillus attached to the superior constrictor muscle and pterygomandibular raphe. Here we have body of the sphenoid bone which form the roof of the nasopharynx, and posteriorly on this bone we have pharyngeal tubercle which attached to the some fibers of the superior constrictor muscle. More posteriorly we have occipital condyle, foramen magnum, hypoglossal canal or foramen, condylar canal. This is posterior border of the foramen magnum. We have external occipital crest, protuberance, superior nuchal line, inferior nuchal line. This is mastoid process. This is mastoid groove or mastoid notch. And this groove is for occipital artery. At this side, it is more obvious. This is groove for occipital artery. This is mastoid notch, and this is mastoid process. This is mastoid emissary canal. This is styloid process, and this is stylomastoid foramen, mandibular fossa. This is jugular foramen. Just lateral to it, we have jugular fossa and jugular foramen. This is carotid canal, foramen lacerum. As we see, foramen lacerum, posterior lateral to the foramen lacerum, we have carotid canal. This is foramen spinosum. Between the foramen spinosum and carotid canal, we have auditory tube or Eustachian tube. And this is foramen ovale. This is greater wing of the sphenoid bone. This is inferior orbital fissure between the posterior surface of maxillary bone. This is maxillary bone posterior aspect, or it's called infratemporal surface. And this is inferior orbital fissure. This area, this fossa, is called pterygopalatine fossa. The area at which the maxillary nerve exits. This is pterygopalatine fossa. This is opening of the foramen rotundum. You can see the wire here. This is maxillary nerve, came from foramen rotundum and open here in the pterygopalatine fossa. Bocipialan pterygopalatine fossa. Bocipialan pterygopalatine fossa. Because it is located between pterygoid plates and perpendicular plate of palatine bone. Perpendicular plate of palatine bone, it is vertical plate of bone of this part of palatine bone, but it is located directed vertically between the nasal cavity and the pterygopalatine fossa. Cavata, perpendicular plate of palatine bone located between nasal cavity medially anterior palatine fossa laterally. Now we have to know the course of maxillary nerve. Maxillary nerve enter the foramen rotundum in the middle cranial fossa. Enter the foramen rotundum. And then exit through the pterygopalatine fossa. You can see the pterygopalatine fossa here. After here, the maxillary nerve pass to two areas. Upper area is inferior orbital fissure, pass to the inferior orbital fissure, and then go to the base or the floor of the orbit. Enter the infraorbital groove, then infraorbital canal, and lastly, exit through the intraorbital foramen. The infraorbital foramen transmit the terminal part of the maxillary nerve, which come from the pterygopalatine fossa. Another part of maxillary nerve pass or descend through this fissure. This is called pterygomaxillary fissure. Fissure located between pterygoid plate and maxillary bone. Transmit the second part of the maxillary nerve. Then pass to the maxilla and supply the anterior teeth, middle and posterior maxillary teeth. This is course of maxillary nerve. Starting from the foramen rotundum, pass to the pterygopalatine fossa, and then either to the inferior orbital fissure or to the maxilla. That's all.